what ran down into the lake pyramid of Giza. Okay, they found it. Hey, I always love it when modern technology backs up ancient tablets.
Careful.
The Emerald Tablets.
Careful.
The Emerald Tablets contain the history of Atlantis. It's the capital size of Sumer.
It's just crows.
The Atlantean ways. The colonization of ancient Egypt and even to the construction of the Great Pyramid, but their real significance that they contain the keys to the unfoldment of the heavens and the earth and the divine soul of man. These tablets were so written that the words responded to the tuned thought waves, releasing the associated mental vibrations of an exhilarating rhythm in the mind of the reader. Thus, the miraculous wisdom of the author is revealed. A casual read will immediately give glimpse
to the must be learning how to dunk it.
The truth seeker who is willing to give them more intensive study will open avenues to the most intrinsic wisdom. Wisdom of unutterable majesty, majesty and beauty. So basically, it's a phenomenal read. I mean, if you read it, you know, I read it 180 times. And the more you read, the more you begin to understand and realize, the more you begin to see. It's not something you want to read just once.
There's five of them there. But I don't know, one of them seems like it's standoffish. Like, it's not quite the little ones. Jackson, I'm serious.
You can get it from the Holy, the Gospel of the Holy 12. Now, it has to be this cover. There's two books out there that have the same name or similar name. This is the Gospel of the Holy 12. I found this one for $650 online on Amazon. Why? Because they don't want you to read the scripture, so it's not in publication. Very hard to find. Sometimes you get lucky and somebody will put a used one for like 50 or 60 bucks, 150 bucks I've seen before. This one was in pristine condition, so I paid the 650 for it. When I look at it, read it,
the little ones are tripping that I put it on the blog.
I asked it for my fingerprints to get on this book, okay? But this is a powerful book because once I read this book, it talks about only where he disappeared to. He went to Egypt, and he actually lived in Coptic Cairo. To learn the Egyptian mysteries, to who? This guy. That's where he went. Now, either he was a son of Thoth, and I really believe that now looking back, he's talking about the son of Thoth. That's where he went. To learn the Egyptian mysteries, then he left there and went to Tibet, and he went to India. To learn mystic arts and Reiki healing, in a sense, teaching reincarnation all the way back. In the Sinai Bible, no crucifixion ever existed. Now they found the book of Jesus' wife, which is the book of Yeshua's wife, which is located in the Harvard Library. So he got married. So the whole thing
is really
a
farce. He got one, didn't he?
But, people have been hoodwinked and betrayed, unfortunately. Was he an amazing person? Yes. Was he amazing with an amazing mission and spirit? Yes. I believe that. Was he a real flesh and blood person that actually walked on this planet? In my personal opinion, it wasn't just about this movement of sun and stars and all. I think he really was the person that was here. Based on the fact that they turned his house into a shrine where he was. I went and visited his house and made pictures of it. So I believe he was a real true person, that he was talking just for this reason. This is why in the New Testament of the Bible, if you read my book, you find that his words mimic identically what Elvis said 36,000 years prior. So which came first, chicken or the egg? He's literally quoting Thoth in the New Testament of the Bible. Anywhere
he can
find every single verse.
To not beg. How can you guys really? Come on, I'm making a documentary.
And teach people there's another level that you can get your consciousness.
Get down.
Written evidence.
Seriously? Just make it impossible to do anything.
Was because of these few verses right here. Because they're really incredible.
Ruined my documentary.
Only the world that broke great waters, drowning and sinking, changing earth's balance, until only the temple of life was left standing on the great mountain of God, still rising out of the water. Some there who were living, saved from the rush of the mountains. So we're now talking about a situation here.
Sorry, pants. They know I'm making a documentary, so they gotta wiggle in.
Extremely long ago,
showing him how they over there. Oh, one of them's right there. Duncan. The other one's there, Duncan. And the one there. Hi, baby.
Far across the waters, until you reach the land of the hairy barbarians, joining the caves of the desert. Follow there the plan that ye know it. So now the waters kind of recited. His dad thought he was also empty.
So cute.
Gather your crew together and set you on a mission. Go out into the desert where
Like, go get it for yourself, man. Then you come over here and dunk it. They haven't fed him. They just keep showing him. Are you serious? Chill out. I'm making a documentary and I scared him.